Hunter from Hunter in the Gym, and
today I'm here with...
What is your name?
Lexi.
How many times have you been in a video? And we've always done that.
Hey, it's Hunter from Hunter in the Gym, and today I'm with...
But you didn't say, and today I'm with...
You should know.
Okay, today we are going to be doing...
Teaching...
Gymnastic skills
on
the laser beam.
Laser beam. And the cool thing about the laser beam is it is pretty thick.
Can't see already.
Let's hope I don't drop it on my toe.
So if you're trying to learn new skills, you get them down on this, and then you can try it on
a big beam.
Not a big beam, just like a normal beam.
So yeah,
let's get started.
Let's get started.
And today I will be teaching the back walkover.
And so, I will be teaching the back handspring, but Lexi's going first because in gymnastics, you are most likely going to do the back walkover first and then the back handspring. Because that would be weird if you learned a back handspring and then a back walkover.
Yeah. So, the first step in learning a back walkover on the beam is to be able to do a bridge on the floor and then move up to the back walkover on the floor. So, if you don't know what a back walkover is, which most of you probably do, it is this. So, that's back walkover. Now we're going to do that on the beam. First step you need to do is learn how to do like a bridge on the beam, if you kind of don't know already. But you can just like lean back and keep your leg up. Don't have your leg come down though. And then you can like push over. So then you can do that a few times. And then you can just like smoothly go into the back walkover motion so that it looks like this. And then when you're starting here, you don't want your foot to go down, you just want to keep it up. So if you need something to like put under your foot to not like have it go down, you can put that there, then you can just go in the back walkover. So the back walkover is pretty easy to do.
So yeah, make sure you guys really do what Lexi says, because when Lexi said, make sure you keep your foot up, that's really smart of her to say, because I actually have a problem with putting my foot down. So once you guys can use it at our gym, we use our foam blocks that we use in the pit, but you can use something different. So
like, maybe just like...
Come on, can you throw me one of my ankle weights? Big crew, pit crew.
Yeah.
So what you can do, an ankle weight would be perfect because what you can do is you can just have it like nice and tight like this. And then just have it upright like this, because this will give your foot a little bit a little bit more height, and you won't be dropping it on the beam. So and then
ow, that hurt.
Don't kick it like a soccer ball.
And this is why I don't.
And then what you can do, if you guys are like, well, I don't want to start with my foot on the beam because I don't want to go back to my old habit. It's not smart to do a walkover on the beam like that. So you can have your foot like an inch up above the ground, like what I'm doing. I'm having my foot like a little bit over the three, because there's numbers, 2, 3, 4. Like four, you're going crooked, 2, you're going crooked, you're going to be like right on the three.
Or the boot line.
Yeah.
Whoa!
And Hunter's on the floor.
See, Lexi is great at back walkovers. Me, no.
Where Hunter is great at back handsprings, and I'm not.
Okay, so on to your back handspring tutorial.
Yes. So
make sure you know how to do it first on the floor.
Before you know how to do it on the beam. On the beam, you can do single back handsprings, like with your feet together, but 90% of the time you do them step out, so make sure you know how to do a back handspring and a back handspring step out. And on beam, you want your back handspring to be really high. So before you go into the beam, try doing higher back handsprings. Like, make it seem like you're almost floating. And then you also want to have your hands like this, because if your hands are like this,
you're gonna slip off and hit your face and break your nose.
Doesn't sound fun.
And you can also grip the beam. So like when you're like this, you can like have your fingers gripping the beam. But I don't grip the beam. I am a daredevil. And my hands are like this. And every time the ghosts just feel like I'm gonna die because I don't grip the beam. And whenever they see me do back handsprings, it'll be a really good back handspring. They're like, because I don't grip the beam.
I am teaching this step out because I don't know how to do single back handsprings on the beam. So I don't want to teach it if I don't know how to do it.
See, and the coach make fun of me because 90% of the time I make my back handsprings. 50% of the time I make my back walkovers.
That's like 140.
What?
And make sure you guys don't turn your hips, because I have crooked hips, crooked dot hunter. I turn my hips and then it gives me a bigger chance of falling. So my coaches, what they had me do for like one time, because they didn't like it, they had me do this one time. It was, and landing like that. And then they're like, "Ew, we don't like it." So we changed it. So I'm just gonna show you guys some. I'm doing like five of them because I need to work on not turning out my hips, because that is a really big problem for me.
And plus, if you turn out your hips, sometimes it could become a really bad habit, and you don't want that to be a habit.
Yeah. Because then it'll be really hard for you to land in. Why were you pointing at me? Wow, Mom, thanks.
No reason.
I landed it just
off the beam.
On a different apparatus.
Think outside the box or outside the beam.
So like when you land on your butt, you made it just on your
you
butt.
Stuck it on your butt.
Exactly. Tell that to the judge.
And as you guys saw, I went like that. If I didn't turn, I would have fell, because it's really hard to land anything like this. So today we are giving an Instagram shout out to
Danielle
Klaber.
So, bye guys. Hope you enjoyed this video.
Hope you guys enjoyed this video.
Peace out.
Love you all. Subscribe, like, follow us on Instagram, follow me on Twitter, and follow us both on Instagram.
Musically.
Yeah. And Lexi can show her skill one more time, and I'll show mine.
Okay. Yeah. Ooh, that was bad.
Ta-da. Don't do that.
Here's mine.
Whoa.
Amazon's here.